Today, I'm going to show you 5 reasons not to use a cloud-based virtual machine. There are good reasons to use cloud-based virtual machines, and I did a whole video on that, but in this video, I'll discuss some of the reasons not to use one. Now, a cloud-based virtual machine is a computer that runs on a cloud service, such as Microsoft Azure, Amazon Web Services, Google Cloud, IBM. They're a key part of a cloud-based infrastructure and a key part of migrating to the cloud. However, they're not a complete solution for every situation. Probably the biggest question I get relates to video gaming on a cloud system, which I'll address in one of the reasons that I give in this video why you should not use a cloud-based virtual machine. However, I'll also offer some really interesting advice on how to run virtual video gaming through a cloud-based service. I'll do that near the end of the video. So if you're interested in video games and cloud-based systems, stay tuned. So let's take a look at the 5 reasons why you should not use a cloud-based virtual machine. Reason number 1, a slow or no internet connection. Now, it should be pretty obvious, but it bears saying you can't connect to a cloud service if you can't connect to the internet. So if you're traveling to remote locations or you're in a non-connected environment on a frequent basis, then you won't be able to access any of those cloud machines while you're in that environment. What about a slow connection? Well, you're effectively only transferring keystrokes, video, and mouse movements through the internet to control your VM, and that can be done even in pretty low bandwidth situations. However, it can still become challenging on a really slow internet connection, mostly if we're dealing with audio and video. Now, this of course is less of an issue if you're running on a command line operating system, but a slow internet for audio and video, that's not a great combo. Reason number 2, you already have the computer you need. Well, I still think learning how to create a cloud-based computer is a good idea for future-proofing your skill set. There's really no sense jumping into building a cloud-based one if you already have the computer that does everything you need it to do. Maybe over time as your computer gets older, but don't spend money you've already spent if you don't have to. If you already have that computer, you already have that computer. Which brings us to reason number 3. You want to run Apple's Mac operating system. Well, there's not too much to say about this. Apple sells hardware and software together. It doesn't license their operating system to outside companies. And as a longtime Mac user, I do remember a brief period back in the 90s when they did license their operating system. And I can understand why they no longer do that. Those Apple clones were not that great, in my opinion. So, you know, if you want to get an Apple system, having the hardware and the software engineered together, it just makes good sense, but that's another video topic altogether. As for modern cloud-based implementations, I don't know if Apple will ever enter that area of the commercial cloud. They're really at a consumer end with their systems, and they do have iCloud, which works with their systems to back up your data and such, but they don't offer the ability to run the entire Apple operating system online, maybe in the future. If that ever happens, I'll certainly be making videos on that. Oh, and before the comment section gets out of hand, it is possible to create a Mac operating system virtual machine, but not in this video. So, reason number 4, you want to be able to mine cryptocurrency like Bitcoin. So let's open up a whole bunch of virtual machines in the cloud and we'll just make a whole bunch of money. Well, there's several reasons why this won't work. Probably the most relevant reason is that you'll spend more money on running the virtual machine than you'll earn from running it. I mean, do you really think I'd be making videos on YouTube if I could just mine Bitcoins using cheap virtual machines? Well, I would because I do like it here, but I wouldn't be asking you to hit the like button and promote my videos because I'd be so rich I wouldn't have to even do anything. I'd go all Mr. Beast. I'd give away complete schools of technology for learning. Enough dreaming. Off to reason number 5. Reason number 5, you're a gamer. Or you do heavy graphic processing unit, GPU intensive work, which is familiar to reason number 4. Mining takes a lot of GPU power. But let's look at gaming specifically. At this point in time, I haven't found that cloud-based VMs are really good for graphics, especially gaming scenarios that are both graphically intense and require low latency. Now, there is an interesting option if you are a gamer and you still want to work with cloud-based gaming systems. It's from Google and it's called Stadia. And I was actually there before it launched, so I became a premier member. And what you can do is you can, it's interesting how they handled the graphics in the cloud. I know these reviews are a little bit mixed on Stadia itself, but I'm happy with the level of gameplay that Google offers with Stadia. It has banks and banks of graphics cards dedicated to running these games, and then what you do is you connect through the cloud to those graphic cards. So this might be a way around the limitation of traditional cloud computing systems, which are not good for running gaming. So don't run a VM in the cloud expecting to have a great gaming system. If you really want to, consider going to something like a Stadia. So are there any reasons to create cloud-based virtual machines? Well, of course there's many, and check out my other video on the channel where I talk about five reasons why you should create a virtual machine in the cloud. Just before you click it though, hit the like button to show me some YouTube love and make this video get seen by others. Thank you so much for watching.